In this video, we're going to set up a recurring journal entry. Recurring journal entries in Intacct allows you to post journals on a regular basis based on the time frame that you set up. They are best used when everything's going to be exactly the same, except for the date. That means the dimensions are the same, the values are the same, everything's the same. If there's going to be a difference, like say you have a recurring let's say you have a recurring depreciation entry and it's not straight lined. Maybe it varies. Recurring entry is not going to work for you because you have to go in there and change it every month, which defeats the purpose of recurring entry. In that case, you'd be better off going to journal entries, finding the prior journal entry for that, and duplicating it. Let's see, zero view transactions. And just come in here, click in view, and duplicate and changing whatever you need to change and posting it. However, if you're doing recurring entries, and notice this time I used a little plus sign. I haven't done that one yet for you. You'll come in here, you have a transaction tab and a schedule tab. The schedule tab is what you're gonna set it up for. Transaction is gonna be your actual entry that's gonna post each time. You can choose which book it's gonna go into, and you have to choose the book that it's gonna post to in order to choose the journal. You can choose, you have all these books to choose from, but if you have it set to all books, it's going to show every journal that's in those books. Now, that's kind of crazy, really. So since we're doing a journal entry, let's go to our accrual book. Come here, still got a lot of journals in here because it's the accrual book. Let's choose general journal because I like my general journal. First, recurring entry. You can give a reference number if you want to or not. Now, if you notice, this layout is not the same. What happened? Well, I didn't come in here and change it because I didn't list them on advice and I forgot. Let's go, this will be a good time to show you how this works. Go in and edit entry layouts. First thing you want to do is check this so it applies to all views. You can move the document down. Any place where you see the little gray line means that's where it'll land. Let's land it down there. I'm going to want to bring up project job up here. We see a little gray bar, put it there. Cost code up here. Cost, if I can get my mouse to work right, cost type up here. I'm not worried about transaction currency because I'm not using multi-currency in this case. I don't care about this base debit. It's just taking up space. I don't care about the base credit in this particular case because we're not doing multi-currency. I want to move my department over. And really, I'm not using the department that much. So I could move it down, but I'm a habit. I stick to my old habits. Allocation. Now it looks like what we have on all of our others. I do that. If I want to, I could bring some of these others up. I can click Save Layout. And maybe it'll save. Thank you. And there, now it looks like our other screens. All right, so choose books. We don't have to keep it there. Once I have my general journal, that's all that matters. Let's choose our project. Let's just do Dallas, just for fun. You guys are in construction. Y'all tell me what would be a good one. Or recurring, I don't really know, but let's just scroll down and see what we can find. I used to work construction electrical, so let's do electrical. Cost type we don't have for this particular one, so I'm not going to go into how to add it on the fly right now. That's for another time. We'll keep it like it is. Don't have an allocation. Let's say our electrical. It says materials. Let's put in. That's $1,500. Tab. Keep it on this job. I'm not going to worry about the cost code for here. And let's say we bought it. Oh, I don't know. Let's say we bought it with cash. So we're going to take it out of our cash account just for giggles here. And it's going to happen all the time. Yeah, I know this example sucks, but it's all I can come up with right away. Maybe one day I'll come up with something better. Then we'll come over here, come to schedule. So that's our entry. As you notice, it doesn't give you a total. Well, it does. I wonder why it doesn't total. I don't know. Let me see. Should have given one, but anyway, I know it totals out. Schedule. You have to choose your start date. This is going to be the date that you want it to start posting the journal entry. If you post it to a past period, it will retroactively post. So that also means, here it says you entered a scheduled start date that's already passed. The system may or may not create transactions for the lapsed period based on the options you set in your schedules. I can tell you from my experience, it will retroactively post. And if you have already, say you have a year's worth of transactions posted and you come in here and you make a change, and then you come to the schedule and you don't change this date and you click save, it's going to repost that whole year so you can have duplicate entries. So if you create a recurring entry and you come here and make a change, you need to change a start date up to the next start date. You'll find out if you make the mistake and you won't forget it. Ending on, you can either choose never, so always repost. You can choose after a number of occurrences, or you can give it an end date. Let's do ours for number of occurrences, end after 3 months. How do I know 3 months? Because you can choose post and repeat by none, means it only posts one time, which kind of defeats the purpose of it. Days, weeks, months, years. Let's make it weeks instead of months. I do it every 1 week. And this is the email you would want to send it to if it fails to post. So what happens is if this fails to post, whoever's on the email here will get a notification saying, hey, you need to go check it out, it didn't post. You can also automatically reverse this journal entry if need to. When you're done, click save. And there we have it. Now, it does not automatically, it takes a moment, especially if you're posting in the past, it takes a moment to catch up. So it'll say zero first. And give it a minute or two and hit refresh. Let's see. See, it's already posted 3 times. Last posted result was success. Post here. It shows you what's posted. Since it's 3 times, this will be it. It will not post again because I only had it post 3 times. You can look at your success results. In transit. Success. So it will not post again. It posted 3 times. So to do it again, you'd have to come there and create a new one. Let's go to our general ledger real fast. General ledger. I did cost of material. Current month, click view. And there they are, all 3 of them. Come in here and look at them. Ta-da, click at history. Create a post. All right. And that's recurring entries. Now, this works the same for statistical journal entries, where you have the recurring statistical, except it'll be posting stat data.